Earth, Wind, and Fire, EWF, is an American band that has spanned the musical genres of R&B, soul, funk, jazz, disco, pop, rock, Latin, and African. They are one of the most successful bands of all time. Rolling Stone magazine described them as innovative, precise yet sensual, calculated yet galvanizing, and declared that the band changed the sound of black pop. The band was founded in Chicago by Maurice White in 1970, having grown out of a previous band known as the Salty Peppers. Other members have included Philip Bailey, Verdine White, Ralph Johnson, Larry Dunn, Al McKay, and Andrew Woolfolk. The band has received 20 Grammy nominations. They won 6 as a group, and 2 of its members, Maurice White and Bailey, won separate individual awards. Earth, Wind, and Fire have 12 American Music Awards nominations and 4 awards. They have been inducted into the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame and the Vocal Group Hall of Fame, received a star on the Hollywood Walk of Fame, and have sold over 100 million records, making them one of the world's best-selling bands of all time. 5 members of Earth, Wind, and Fire were also inducted into the Songwriters Hall of Fame: Maurice White, Philip Bailey, Verdine White, Larry Dunn, and Al McKay. The music industry and fans have bestowed lifetime achievement honors from the American Society of Composers, Authors, and Publishers, Rhythm and Soul Heritage Award 2002, NAACP, Hall of Fame 1994, and the BET Awards, Lifetime Achievement Award 2002. Earth, Wind, and Fire is known for the dynamic sound of their horn section, their energetic and elaborate stage shows, and the interplay between the contrasting vocals of Philip Bailey's falsetto and Maurice White's tenor. The kalimba, African thumb piano, is played on all of the band's albums. In the 1970s and early 1980s, the band had many hits, including Shining Star, That's the Way of the World, Devotion, Reasons, Sing a Song, Can't Hide Love, Getaway, Fantasy, Love's Holiday, September, Boogie Wonderland, After the Love Has Gone, and Let's Groove. 2 Earth, Wind, and Fire classic songs have been inducted into the Grammy Hall of Fame: That's the Way of the World, 2004, and Shining Star, 2007. The band is also known as having been the first African-American act to sell out Madison Square Garden and to receive the Message Gold Ticket Award. President Barack Obama invited Earth, Wind, and Fire to perform at the White House for the first social event of the new administration. History. Beginnings, 1969-1970. In 1969, Maurice White, a former session drummer for Chess Records and former member of the Ramsey Lewis Trio, joined 2 friends in Chicago, Wade Flemons and Don Whitehead, as a songwriter team composing songs and commercials in the Chicago area. The 3 friends got a recording contract with Capitol. They called themselves the Salty Peppers and had a marginal hit in the Midwestern area called La La Time. The Salty Peppers' second single, Aha Yet, did not fare as well, and Maurice moved from Chicago to Los Angeles. He then added to the band singer Sherry Scott and percussionist Yaakov Ben Israel, both from Chicago, and then asked his younger brother Verdine how he would feel about heading out to the West Coast. On June 6, 1970, Verdine left Chicago to join the band as their new bassist. Maurice began shopping demo tapes of the band, featuring Donny Hathaway, around to different record labels, and the band was thus signed to Warner Brothers Records. Formation in early years, 1970-1973. Maurice's astrological sign, Sagittarius, has a primary elemental quality of fire and seasonal qualities of earth and air, according to classical triplicities. Sagittarius in the northern hemisphere occurs in the autumn, whose element is earth, and in the southern hemisphere, it is spring, whose element is air. Hence the omission of water, the 4th classical element. Based on this, he changed the band's name to Earth, Wind, and Fire. Maurice held further auditions in LA, adding Michael Bale on guitar, Chester Washington on reeds, and Leslie Drayton on trumpet. Drayton also served as the group's musical arranger. Trombonist Alex Thomas completed the then 10-man EWF lineup. The band's self-titled debut album, Earth, Wind, and Fire, was released in February 1971 to critical acclaim, as was November 1971's The Need of Love. Both albums were produced by Joe Wissard, and a single, From The Need of Love called I Think About Lovin' You, with Sherry Scott on lead vocals, provided EWF with their first top 40 R&B hit. In 1971, the group also recorded the soundtrack of the Melvin Van Peebles film Sweet Sweetback's Baddest Song. The soundtrack was recorded at Paramount Recording Studios on Santa Monica Boulevard and released on Stax Records. The band developed a growing popularity on college campuses, but, in spite of this, some members of EWF started to become restless and the band broke up after having been together less than 6 months. With only Verdine left, Maurice decided to reform the group. In 1972, Maurice added vocalist Helena Davis, who was soon replaced by Jessica Cleaves, a former member of the R&B group The Friends of Distinction, Ronnie Laws on the flute and saxophone, rhythm guitarist Roland Bautista, keyboardist Larry Dunn, percussionist Ralph Johnson, and vocalist and Denver native Philip Bailey to the group. Warner Brothers didn't know how to promote this new combo, as the only other funk band on their label was Charles Wright and the Watts 103rd Street Rhythm Band. The band successfully auditioned for managers Bob Cavallo and Joe Ruffalo. Cavallo's management of John Sebastian led to a series of gigs as the opening act for the pop folk singer and the Lovin' Spoonful founder. A performance at New York's Rockefeller Center introduced EWF to Clive Davis, then the president of Columbia Records. Davis was very impressed with the band's performance and bought their contract from Warner Brothers. Their debut album on CBS Columbia Records, Last Days and Time, featured mostly original material, but Bailey had recommended that the band cover the Pete Seeger song Where Have All the Flowers Gone, and the band also remade the Bread hit Make It With You. The album also includes the original, Maurice penned, composition Power, an up-tempo 8-minute instrumental. In stark contrast to the ballads, Power features extended fuzz guitar and soprano saxophone solos set against a driving funk beat. Classic period, 1973-1980. The album Head to the Sky was released in the spring of 1973 and gave the group their first two legitimate hit singles, Evil, CO written by Maurice and Philip, and Keep Your Head to the Sky, both of which reached the top 30 and the top 60 on the R&B and pop charts, respectively. Prior to this album's release, some personnel changes took place as Roland Bautista and Ronnie Laws left the band to pursue new musical opportunities. Philip Bailey had recommended his former Denver East High School classmate, saxophonist Andrew Woolfolk, to the band as replacement for Laws. Woolfolk had been busy in New York studying sax with sax maestro Joe Henderson and was about to start a career in banking when Bailey called. To fill the void created by Bautista's departure, guitarists Al McKay, who had performed with the Ike and Tina Turner Review and the Watts 103rd St. Rhythm Band, and Johnny Graham from R&B group New Birth were added to round out the new lineup. Jessica Cleaves following the release of the album was also their last to be produced by Joe Wissert. As some of the band's songs required lower register vocals than Bailey's, and due to the success of Evil, Maurice altered his role in the group to incorporate that of lead vocalist. Recorded at Colorado's Caribou Ranch Studio and released in 1974, Open Our Eyes was a commercially successful LP, selling over 1 million copies in the U.S. and thus was certified platinum. At Morris's request, Open Our Eyes was co-produced by Charles Stepney with White. Stepney had previously worked with the Dells, the Rotary Connection, Terry Callier, Minnie Riperton, and the Ramsey Lewis Trio, to name a few. Released in May 1974, the single Mighty Mighty became Earth, Wind, and Fire's first top 30 hit on the pop charts, peaking at number 29. Another single, Devotion, was a song with a strong spiritual message. Following the completion of this album, Morris's younger brother, Fred White, joined the band. Fred had played in Chicago clubs as a drummer with Donnie Hathaway and Little Feat. On April 6, 1974, Earth, Wind and Fire performed at the California Jam, a West Coast rock festival that attracted an audience of 200,000. Also in 1974, the band collaborated with Ramsey Lewis on his album Sun Goddess, which reached number one on the Billboard Jazz and Black Album charts and was certified gold in the U.S. by the RIAA. In 1975, Earth, Wind and Fire was approached by Sig Shore, producer of the motion picture Superfly, to record the soundtrack to new film about the dark side of the recording industry called That's the Way of the World. The film also starred EWF as a new recording act known as The Group. They performed songs in the film and Maurice had a small speaking part, as leader of the group. In the film Harvey Keitel's character hears the group performing and produces their first album. The film's title is repeated throughout the film as a shrug of the shoulders to the music world. When the band saw the film, they were convinced that the motion picture would be a bomb, which it eventually was. To avoid being connected with the movie, they released the album soundtrack, also entitled That's the Way of the World, before its premiere. Recorded at the Caribou Ranch Studio and co-produced by Maurice White and Charles Stepney, That's the Way of the World became Earth, Wind and Fire's breakthrough album, spending 3 weeks at number one on the Billboard Pop Albums charts, 5 non-consecutive weeks atop the Soul Albums chart. That's the Way of the World was also warmly received critically. For instance, AllMusic's Alex Henderson described the album as one of the strongest albums of the 70s and EWF's crowning achievement, and Billboard magazine called it a very tightly produced and performed package. The album made EWF the first black act to top both the Billboard album and singles charts and was certified triple platinum in the US by the RIAA. Included on the album were the hit singles Shining Star, which rose to number one on the R&B singles and Billboard Hot 100 and won the band a Grammy Award for Best R&B Performance by a Duo or Group with Vocals, and That's the Way of the World, which went to number 5 and number 12 on the R&B singles and Billboard Hot 100, respectively. Because of the album's tremendous commercial success, the band was able to hire a full horn section, which was dubbed the Phoenix Horns. The Phoenix Horns, who became an integral part of the band's sound, were composed of saxophonist Don Myrick, trombonist Louis Satterfield, and trumpeters Romley Davis and Michael Harris. Myrick and Satterfield both worked with Maurice during his days as a session drummer at Chess Records. Subsequent to EWF's first tour of Europe, where they opened for the rock band Santana, Columbia Records wanted another album released as soon as possible. As a result, EWF returned to the studio in June 1975, and from these recording sessions two singles, Sing a Song and Can't Hide Love, the latter written by Clarence Skip Scarborough, were spawned. These and other studio recordings were included, along with mostly live concert material from their 1974 and 1975 tours, on the double album Gratitude, released in late 1975. Gratitude rose to and stayed at number one on the pop and R&B charts for 3 weeks and 6 weeks respectively. It was also the second best-selling R&B album of 1976 and is certified triple platinum for sales of over 3 million copies in the US by the RIAA. The band was nominated for Grammy Award for Best R&B Performance by a Duo or Group with Vocals for the title track, Gratitude. Can't Hide Love was also Grammy nominated for Best Arrangement for Voices. Earth, Wind and Fire also won a Rock Music Award in the category of Best Soul Album for Gratitude and Downbeat Magazine's Reader's Poll for Favorite Rock Blues Group in 1975. Additionally, in 1975 Maurice established a production company called Kalimba Productions, to which he signed artists such as his former band leader Ramsey Lewis, singer Danyake Williams, a former member of Stevie Wonder's Wonder Love backup group, and girl group The Emotions, who had a run of hits with Stax Records from 1969 to 1974. Maurice loaned the band's signature Phoenix Horns and most of the other band members and put on tour with Earth, Wind and Fire. These artists and others who were signed to Kalimba Productions. After helping co-produce and arrange Earth, Wind and Fire's new album, Danyake Williams's debut album, This Is Nisi, Ramsey Lewis's Salongo, and The Emotions' first Columbia Records album Flowers, Charles Stepney died of a heart attack on May 17, 1976 in Chicago at the age of 43. With Stepney's passing, Maurice took over and completed the production of the band's new album, Spirit, which was released October 1976. EWF paid tribute to Stepney in the form of the album's title. The album reached number 2 on the Billboard Pop and R&B Albums chart and was certified double platinum in the US by the RIAA. Additionally, Spirit spawned the hit singles Getaway and Saturday Night. During this period, EWF concerts started to become loaded with pyrotechnics, magic, laser lights, flying pyramids, levitating guitarists and elaborate production tricks that included the entire group ascending in a pyramid and a disappearing act. Magician Doug Henning directed many of their tours throughout the 1970s with his young assistant, David Copperfield. The band also began to be choreographed by George Faison. In November 1977, the group released another studio LP, All in All. With an Egyptian postmodernistic-themed album cover, All in All featured the hit singles Serpentine Fire and Fantasy, and achieved triple platinum status. This album was the first of several to feature striking cover art by the Japanese artist Shusei Nagaoka. In 1978, EWF picked up 3 Grammy Awards, the third for their rendition of the Beatles' Got to Get You Into My Life. EWF's performance of the song was included on the soundtrack for the movie S.G.T. Pepper's Lonely Hearts Club Band. The film was a commercial failure, however, Got to Get You Into My Life was the biggest hit from the movie's soundtrack, reaching numbers 1 and 9 on the R&B and pop singles charts, respectively. 1978 was also the year that Maurice and EWF's managers Cavallo and Ruffalo worked out a deal for the launch of a new record label called the American Recording Company, ARC, to be distributed through CBS, and the creation of a recording studio, George Massenburg ARC, also called The Complex, in West Los Angeles. The year ended with the release of another hit single, entitled September, which was added to the quintuple platinum compilation album, The Best of Earth, Wind and Fire, Volume 1, released on November 23, 1978. At this time, Bobby Harris of the Daz Band requested and got Philip Bailey to produce the group's first album, Kinsman Daz. Bailey had major input into the group's vocal arrangements and would go on to co-produce the band's second album, Daz. January 1979, saw the band performing September and That's the Way of the World at the Music for UNICEF concert, which was broadcast worldwide from the United Nations General Assembly by NBC. Other artists performing at the event were ABBA, the Bee Gees, Olivia Newton-John, Donna Summer and Rod Stewart. Subsequent to this performance, the band donated the royalties from one of their songs to UNICEF and began a tour of Europe and Japan. The group's 9th album overall, 7th for Columbia Records, and 2nd released on the ARC label was I Am. It was another smash hit, going double platinum and reaching numbers 3 and 1 on the R&B and pop charts, respectively. Singles spawned from this album included In the Stone, Can't Let Go, and the sad David Foster Bill Champlin written ballad After the Love Has Gone, which rose to the number 2 spot on the Billboard Pop and R&B charts and won a Grammy for the Best R&B Vocal Performance by a Duo or Group in 1980. Though the band had previously overlooked disco, the summer of 1979 saw EWF topping the dance music charts with their most disco-inspired single, Boogie Wonderland, which was produced by Maurice and Al McKay and featured the Emotions. Even with the song's success, Verdeen White claims that the band is not a disco band, saying, "I guess you could say we were at the party but didn't get on the dance floor." In October 1980, the double album Faces was released and rose to number 2 and number 10 in the R&B and pop charts, respectively. It earned gold status in the US. In a 2007 interview, when asked which EWF album was his favorite, Maurice White replied, "Probably Faces because we were really in tune, playing together and it gave us the opportunity to explore new areas." After the release of this album, longtime rhythm guitarist Al McKay left the band for personal and professional reasons. He was replaced by returning rhythm guitarist Roland Bautista, who gave the band a bit of a hard rock sound with his style of playing. Electronic period, 1981-1990. White decided that, given the changing musical landscape, the band needed to incorporate into their work more of the digital sound which was popular at the time. As a result, EWF's 11th album, Raise, was influenced by this new electronic sound and released in the fall of 1981. It sold more than 1 million copies in the US. Raise featured the hit single Let's Groove, which also went platinum, and another single Wanna Be With You, which won EWF a Grammy for Best R&B Vocal Performance by a Duo or Group. Earth, Wind and Fire appeared at American Bandstand's 30th anniversary special, where they performed Let's Groove on October 30, 1981. 2 years after the release of Raise, came Power Light, which included the singles Fall in Love with Me, a number 17 pop hit, and Side by Side. Power Light went gold. Also in 1983, the band contributed the song Dance, Dance, Dance to the soundtrack of the animated film Rock and Rule. After the fully synthesized album Electric Universe was released in late 1983 to a poor critical and commercial reception, Maurice believed the band needed a break, so he put EWF on hiatus in early 1984. During their hiatus, Philip Bailey released his second and most commercially successful solo project, the gold album Chinese Wall, featuring the Phoenix Horns and produced by Phil Collins. The first single from that album, a duet with Collins called Easy Lover, sold over 1 million copies, rose to number 2 on the US Billboard Hot 100 and number 1 on the UK Singles Chart respectively, and was Grammy nominated for Best Pop Vocal Performance by a Duo or Group. The song's video went to the top of MTV's video playlist and won an MTV Video Music Award for Best Overall Performance in 1985. Bailey released 4 gospel albums in this period, and one of them, titled Triumph, won a Grammy Award for Best Gospel Vocal Performance, Male. Maurice White, during this time, produced for Barbara Streisand on her platinum album Emotion and worked with Neil Diamond on his gold album Headed for the Future and Cher on her 1987 platinum album Cher. He also released the self-titled solo album Maurice White in 1985, which included a cover of Stand By Me that went to number 6 on the R&B charts and number 11 on the Adult Contemporary charts. The album also featured an appearance by saxophonist Gerald Albright. Also, during the hiatus, Verdeen White wrote and directed videos. He produced Standing in the Light, by the English pop rock and jazz funk band Level 42, with Larry Dunn, and promoted go-go bands like Treble Funk and EU. The compilation album The Collection was released May 1986, stayed at number 5 on the UK singles charts for 2 weeks, and was certified gold in the UK by the British phonographic industry. Phil Collins saw EWF on one of their European tours and became a fan of the band. He came in contact with the Phoenix Horns and they eventually worked with his band Genesis on songs including No Reply at All and Paper Late, and on such Collins solo hits as I Missed Again and Sussudio. In 1987, CBS Records convinced both Philip Bailey and Maurice White that a reunion of Earth, Wind and Fire would be fruitful. As a result, original members Verdeen White, Ralph Johnson, and Andrew Woolfolk returned to the band with new members guitarist-vocalist Sheldon Reynolds, lead guitarist Dick Smith, and drummer Sonny Emery. A new horn section dubbed the Earth, Wind, and Fire Horns was also created, made up of Gary Bias on the saxophone, Raymond Lee Brown on the trumpet, and Reggie Young on the flugelhorn and trombone. The band's reformation fostered the 1987 gold album Touch the World, which was nominated for a Soul Train Award in the category of Best R&B Soul Album of the Year and rose to number 3 on the Top R&B Hip Hop Albums chart and number 33 on the Billboard 200. Featured on the album was a song penned by an unknown songwriter by the name of Skylark, titled System of Survival. Released as a single, the song became a hit, going to number 1 on the Billboard R&B charts and dance charts. Another single titled Thinking of You peaked at number 1 and number 3 on the R&B and dance charts as well. In 1988, the band released the compilation album The Best of Earth, Wind and Fire, Volume 2, which went gold in the US. The group's final album released by Columbia Records was 1990's Heritage, which featured a collaboration with Sly Stone of Sly and the Family Stone. In 1992, the band released a 55-track anthology of their career up to that point entitled The Eternal Dance. Neoclassic period, 1993-present. EWF signed once again with Warner Brothers and following this came the release in 1993 of their 16th studio album, Millennium. The album featured the single Sunday Morning, which earned the band a Grammy nomination for Best R&B Vocal Performance by a Duo or Group, the Billboard Top 40 charting single Spend the Night, and a track written by Prince called Superhero. Tragedy befell the band in 1993, on July 30th, former Phoenix Horns saxophonist Don Myrick was fatally shot by the Los Angeles Police Department in a case of mistaken identity. Then on October 13th, former lead vocalist Wade Flemons died from cancer in Battle Creek, Michigan. In 1994, Earth, Wind and Fire were inducted into the NAACP Hall of Fame. The band received another tribute in the following year in the form of a star on the Hollywood Walk of Fame. All the original members of the group attended the inauguration ceremony, and in his speech Maurice White attributed EWF's success to the support of all of their fans. In 1994, White retired from touring with the band. At the time, he explained that he wanted to take a rest from the rigors of the road. Philip Bailey was given the role of onstage leader of the band. The studio album In the Name of Love was released on Pyramid Records in 1997 to a favorable critical reception. EWF performed at the 1997 Montreux Jazz Festival and gave an encore performance the following year. In 2004, a DVD of their 1997 performance was released, entitled Earth, Wind and Fire, Live at Montreux 1997. In 1999, the group performed on the Andy Network show Live by Request, and in that same year Maurice revealed that the real reason for his ending his touring days in 1995 was because he had contracted Parkinson's disease in the late 1980s, which made it increasingly difficult for him over the years to handle the rigors of touring. A website entitled www.startalk.org was set up in 1999 to offer Maurice support with his health struggles, and on it were published messages of encouragement from celebrities such as Steven Tyler of Aerosmith, Boyz II Men, Smokey Robinson, Isaac Hayes, Michael Jackson, Eric Clapton, and Tom Morello of Rage Against the Machine. Maurice, however, had the disease under control, so much so that he occasionally made appearances at Earth, Wind, and Fire performances, and continued to write, record, produce and develop new recordings for Earth, Wind, and Fire and other artists. On March 6, 2000, Earth, Wind, and Fire was inducted into the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame to a standing ovation during the 15th annual induction dinner held at New York's Waldorf Astoria Hotel. All of the band's original members from the 1973-80 classic period, namely Maurice White, Philip Bailey, Verdine White, Ralph Johnson, Al McKay, Larry Dunn, Andrew Wufolk, Fred White, and Johnny Graham, attended the ceremony, at which the nine of them played together for the first time in 20 years, performing Shining Star and That's the Way of the World. After their induction into the Hall of Fame, an effort was made by the original band members to fully reunite, but it ultimately proved unfruitful. Earth, Wind, and Fire were the specially invited music guests at the June 20, 2000 White House State Dinner hosted by President Bill Clinton on the South Lawn of the White House, in honor of His Majesty Mohammed VI, King of Morocco, and Her Royal Highness Princess Lala Mariam. So impressed was the King by the band's performance that he made a successful personal request for EWF to perform in Morocco for his 37th birthday celebration, on August 21, 2000. In 2001, a biographical documentary of the band entitled Shining Stars, The Official Story of Earth, Wind, and Fire was released, directed by Catherine Arnold. Following the September 11 attacks of that year, the band members donated $25,000 to the American Red Cross at a September 13 show at Virginia's Verizon Wireless Virginia Beach Amphitheater, the band's first concert since those events took place. February 24, 2002 saw Earth, Wind, and Fire performing at the closing ceremonies of the 2002 Winter Olympics held in Salt Lake City, Utah. A live album from the band's 1980 performance in Rio de Janeiro, Brazil, entitled Live in Rio, was released on Maurice White's Kalimba Records label in 2002. And that same year EWF was honored with the Rhythm and Soul Heritage Award from the American Society of Composers, Authors, and Publishers at the Beverly Hilton Hotel in Beverly Hills, California. The award was presented to EWF by ASCAP President and Chairman Marilyn Bergman, Stevie Wonder, and Jimmy Jam. In addition, the band was inducted into the Vocal Group Hall of Fame and Hollywood's Rock Walk in 2003. In 2003, Kalimba Records released The Promise, the band's first studio album in 6 years. The Promise rose to number 19 on the top Rand hip-hop albums charts and received critical acclaim upon its release, with People magazine and Blender magazine describing the album as musically rich and a classy collection, respectively. The track Hold Me, produced and written by Tim and Bob, was Grammy-nominated for Best Traditional R&B Vocal Performance. The album spawned a Kalimba-laden track reminiscent of the classic WANF sound, titled All in the Way, which reunited EWF with the emotions. Featured on the album were two previously unreleased songs from the I Am recording sessions, Where Do We Go From Here and Dirty. On February 8, 2004, Earth, Wind and Fire performed in a tribute to funk at the 46th Annual Grammy Awards held at the Staples Center, Los Angeles, California. Other artists performing at this tribute were Parliament Funkadelic, Outkast, and Robert Randolph and the Family Band. EWF sang Shining Star and then at Outkast's request crooned The Way You Move with them. Robert Randolph and the Family Band performed their single I Need More Love and then all of the bands teamed to sing Parliament Funkadelic's classic Give Up the Funk, Tear the Roof Off the Sucker. Earth, Wind, and Fire contributed to the Jimi Hendrix tribute album Power of Soul, a tribute to Jimi Hendrix, released in May 4, 2004, with their cover of Voodoo Child, Slight Return. In the summer of 2004, Earth, Wind, and Fire signed a record deal with Sanctuary Urban Records, owned by Matthew Knowles, father and manager of R&B pop singer Beyoncé. Gary Bias and Bob Burns, Jr., of the Earth, Wind, and Fire horns were featured on Queen Latifah's The Dana Owens album, which was released on September 28, 2004, and reached 16 and 11 on the Billboard 200 and Top R&B Hip-Hop Album charts, respectively, and was certified gold. On September 27, 2004, former Phoenix Horns trombonist Louis Satterfield died, aged 67. Kenny G's cover of The Way You Move, which was released in November 2004 and charted at number 12 on the Adult Contemporary Singles chart, featured the band with Maurice and Philip on lead vocals. EWF and Kenny G performed The Way You Move on The Tonight Show with Jay Leno in January 2005. On December 11, 2004, Earth, Wind and Fire were honored at the first annual Grammy Jam held at Los Angeles's Wiltern Theater, where several artists such as Stevie Wonder, Yolanda Adams, Sheila E., Miri Benari, George Duke, Kanye West, and Randy Jackson paid tribute to the band in the form of performances. Other celebrities who attended the event were Pamela Anderson, Tim Allen, Prince, Jimmy Jam, Terry Lewis, Nick Cannon, and Suzanne DePasse. EWF performed on Dick Clark's New Year's Rockin' Eve on December 31, 2004. EWF released a single entitled Show Me the Way, on which they paired with neo-soul artist Rafael Saadic on Sanctuary Records in the fall of 2005. The single garnered a Grammy nomination and was featured on Illumination, their 19th studio album, which was released on September 20, 2005. For this album, EWF collaborated with artists such as Will.i.am, Kelly Rowland, Outkast's Big Boi, and Brian McKnight. Illumination reached number 8 on the Top R&B Hip Hop Album chart and number 32 on the Billboard Hot 100. Another single spawned from the album, dubbed Pure Gold, reached number 23 on the Adult Contemporary charts. The album garnered the admiration of critics, with AllMusic's Rob Theakston referring to the album as an outstanding record and Steve Jones of USA Today remarking that on the album EWF are as vibrant as ever. Illumination received a Grammy nomination for Best R&B Album and a Soul Train Music Award in the category R&B Soul Album. EWF also received a NAACP Image Award nomination for Best Duo or Group. The February 6, 2005, Super Bowl 39 pregame show in Jacksonville, Florida saw the band teaming with the Black Eyed Peas to sing Where Is the Love, and Shining Star. In March 2005, EWF performed in Russia for the first time. In 2004, Earth, Wind and Fire and Chicago embarked upon a joint national tour, which gave rise to a DVD of a concert that took place at Los Angeles Greek Theater entitled Chicago and Earth, Wind and Fire Live at the Greek Theater. This DVD was released on June 28, 2005, and was certified platinum 2 months afterward. Chicago and EWF once again toured together in 2005 and collaborated for a new recording of Chicago's ballad If You Leave Me Now, that was included on Chicago's 2005 compilation album Love Songs as part of an opening act for the 57th Primetime Emmy Awards held on September 18, 2005, at Los Angeles Shrine Auditorium. The band once more collaborated with the Black Eyed Peas. This was first time a musical artist had opened at the annual awards show. In 2005, EWF released their first Christmas-themed track entitled Gather Round, produced and arranged by David Foster and written by Maurice White, Foster, and Philip Bailey. In 2006, Maurice worked with Maurice Hines, the brother of famed entertainer Gregory Hines, to release the Broadway play Hot Feet, which was a jukebox musical whose theme was the music of earth, wind, and fire. Maurice co-wrote with Ollie Willis, who wrote September, Boogie Wonderland, In the Stone, and Sunday Morning for the band several new songs for the play. EWF performed alongside Mary J. Blige and Ludacris' Runaway Love at the 49th Grammy Awards held at Los Angeles's Staples Center. Interpretations, celebrating the music of earth, wind, and fire, an album featuring cover versions of EWF's material, was released on Stax Records on March 27, 2007. Executively produced by Maurice, the album featured artists such as Chaka Khan, Kirk Franklin, Lala Hathaway, Mint Condition, Dweil, Meshel Ndegeocello, and Angie Stone. Dweil and Meshel Ndegeocello's renditions of That's the Way of the World and Fantasy, respectively, were each nominated for the Grammy Award for Best Urban Alternative Performance. The band was the opening act at a special edition of American Idol entitled Idol Gives Back, which aired April 25, 2007. And performed a medley of Boogie Wonderland, Shining Star and September. At the Nobel Peace Prize concert in Oslo, Norway, on December 11, 2007, Earth, Wind and Fire performed Fantasy and September. Hosted by Kevin Spacey and Uma Thurman, the Nobel Peace Prize concert was broadcast to over 100 countries. Other artists who performed included Melissa Etheridge, Alicia Keys, Annie Lennox, and Kylie Minogue. Earth, Wind, and Fire performed on the opening night of one of the largest musical events in Latin America, Chile's Viña del Mar Festival. The band so impressed the audience with their performance that the band was bestowed with the Gaviota de Plata, English translation, the Silver Seagull, the highest award that can be presented to an artist performing at the Viña del Mar Festival. The intro to EWF's song In the Stone has been used for several years as the introductory theme for the event's broadcasts. Maurice White, Ralph Johnson, Philip Bailey, and Verdine White each received an honorary degree from the Arts and Media College at Columbia College Chicago during the college's 2008 commencement exercises. Verdine White and Bailey both gave brief speeches during the ceremony, followed by all four honorees giving an impromptu performance of Shining Star. EWF performed at the opening ceremony of the 2008 U.S. Open, which was hosted by Forrest Whitaker and served to commemorate the 40th anniversary of the founding of tennis's Open era with a parade of more than 25 former U.S. Open singles champions. Earth, Wind, and Fire performed at the White House on February 22, 2009, for the Governor's Dinner. They were the first musical artists to perform there since Barack Obama took office. The band toured once more with Chicago in 2009 for a tour of 30 U.S. cities. On April 26, 2009, EWF performed at the 39th New Orleans Jazz and Heritage Festival. Less than 2 weeks prior to this, former keyboard player Robert Brookins died from a heart attack, aged 46. In 2010, EWF performed at the 40th New Orleans Jazz and Heritage Festival. In that same year, Band members Philip Bailey, Verdine White, and Ralph Johnson participated in the recording of the We Are the World 25 for Haiti single. 2010 was also the year that saw Earth, Wind, and Fire's original members Maurice White, Philip Bailey, Verdine White, Al McKay and Larry Dunn all inducted into the Songwriters Hall of Fame. In November 2011, the band was given the Legend Award at the Soul Train Awards at Atlanta, Georgia's Fox Theater. In 2012, EWF were bestowed with a Lifetime Achievement Award at the 20th Annual Trumpet Awards, held at Cobb Energy Performing Arts Center in Atlanta. On February 29, 2012, early guitarist Roland Bautista died, aged 60, of natural causes. On April 30, 2013, Earth, Wind & Fire were featured vocalists on Something About You, taken from LL Cool J's new album Authentic, LL Cool J album, along with former Pussycat Doll Melody Thornton and Charlie Wilson. Now, Then & Forever, the group's first album in 8 years, was released September 10, 2013. On January 13, 2014, former percussionist Beloyd Taylor, who co-wrote the band's 1976 hit Getaway, died, and on May 2, former vocalist Jessica Cleaves died, aged 65, following complications from a stroke. On September 13, 2014, Earth, Wind & Fire performed at Proms in the Park at Hyde Park with the BBC Concert Orchestra on October 21, 2014, Earth, Wind & Fire released their first ever holiday album entitled Holiday. On December 8, 2014, Earth, Wind & Fire performed at the Kennedy Center Honors, honoring Al Green. On December 14, 2014, Earth, Wind & Fire performed at the Christmas in Washington event. Maurice White died on February 4, 2016, after a suffering for some years with Parkinson's disease. He was survived by his wife, his two sons, and his brothers Verdine and Fred. Influence. Earth, Wind, and Fire's songs have been covered by artists such as Nocaut, Point of Grace, D'Angelo, CDB, Dionne Warwick, The Fifth Dimension, Pomplamoose, Lenny White, Patti LaBelle, The Manhattans, Winona Judd, Yolanda Adams, New York Voices, Donny Osmond, Chaka Khan, 112, The Vienna Boys Choir, Herb Alpert, Music Soulchild, and Tito Puente. Earth, Wind, and Fire's songs have been sampled by numerous artists, including UGK, A Tribe Called Quest, Wyclef Jean, Missy Elliott, Snoop Dogg, NASJZ, Amory, The Fugees, LL Cool J, De La Soul, Common, Frank Zappa, Naughty by Nature, P. Diddy, The Roots, Will Smith, CeeLo Green, Lisa Left Eye Lopes of TLC, Public Enemy, EPMD, Lupe Fiasco, Bone Thugs and Harmony, Tupac Shakur, Brand Nubian and MC Light. Earth, Wind, and Fire have influenced artists such as Beyoncé, Usher, Will.i.am, Janelle Monáe, Mary J. Blige, Prince, Pharrell Williams, India.ari, The Neptunes, John Secada, Wyclef Jean, Common, Phil Collins, Boney James, Angie Stone, Raphael Saadic, The All-American Rejects, Jesse McCartney, Music Soulchild, Solange Knowles, Babyface, Outkast, Jamiroquai, Five for Fighting, Lenny Kravitz, Mark Broussard, Omarion, Rob Borden of Linkin Park, Eric Bennett, Jill Scott, Justin Timberlake, Sheila E., Marcus Miller, Erykah Badu, Jamie Foxx, Patrick Stump of Fall Out Boy, Meshel Enda Giocello, Wynton Marsalis, DNCE, Megan Trainor, and Mario. Miles Davis described EWF as his all-time favorite band, saying, "They have everything, horns, electric guitar, singers, and more, in one band." Quincy Jones has proclaimed himself to be the biggest fan of Earth, Wind, and Fire since day one. Dionne Warwick has named Earth, Wind, and Fire as her favorite group of all time. In the movie Badass, the actor Callal Kane portrayed a young Maurice White leading the early incarnation of Earth, Wind, and Fire. Released at the Sundance Film Festival, The film was based on Melvin Van Peebles' struggle to film and distribute the movie Sweet Sweet Bach's Badish Song and was directed by his son Mario Van Peebles. Earth, Wind, and Fire's songs have also been featured in many movies all over the world. These movies include Anchorman, Last Vegas, The Intouchables, Night at the Museum, and Caddyshack. Earth, Wind, and Fire's songs have also been featured in many television shows. These shows include The Mentalist, True Blood, The Office, Glee, Daredevil, and The Tonight Show with Jay Leno.